Recording. Hello, everybody. Captain Thief. I want to do something kind of special for October. I want something that's more, I don't know, scary, spooky, but not too spooky because I don't really do too well with horror games. So this one's really more horror oriented. And this is going to be the first time I have ever streamed, so, hopefully it goes well for me. There's a particular reason why I wanted to stream though, and that's because this particular game, if you do or don't know, is all about permadeath. And when it comes to permadeath, it's easy to scum things out, and I didn't want to do that. So I wanted to kind of stream it just to kind of prove,
Warning,
hey, I'm
post
not
comm to
scumming
all
this, just so you
problems.
know. I need to turn on my
You
personal volume just a
remember our
smidge.
venerable house?
I'll let this play.
Opulent and imperial, gazing proudly from its stoic perch above the moor. I lived all my years in that ancient, rumor-shadowed manor, fattened by decadence and luxury. And yet I began to tire of conventional extravagance. Singular, unsettling tales suggested the mansion itself was a gateway to some fabulous and unnameable power. With relic and ritual, I bent every effort towards the excavation and recovery of those long-buried secrets, exhausting what remained of our family fortune on swarthy workmen and sturdy shovels. At last, in the salt-soaked crags beneath the lowest foundations, we unearthed that damnable portal of antediluvian evil. Our every step unsettled the ancient earth, but we were in a realm of death and madness. In the end, I alone fled laughing and wailing through those blackened arcades of antiquity, until consciousness failed me. You remember our venerable house, opulent and imperial. It is a festering abomination. I beg you, return home, claim your birthright, and deliver our family from the ravenous, clutching shadows of the darkest dungeon.
Never really got that until now, but that was a gunshot to his own chrome. Darkest Dungeon is about making the most of a bad situation. Quests will fail and or must be abandoned. Heroes will die, and when they die, they stay dead. Progress autosaves constantly, so actions are permanent. The game expects a lot of you. How far will you push your adventurers? How much are you willing to risk in your quest to restore the Hamlet? What will you sacrifice to save the life of your favorite hero? Thankfully, there are always fresh souls arriving on the stagecoach seeking both. I can't read that fast. In the Darkest Dungeon. All right. So I actually played this a couple years ago, and by a couple I mean, well, a while ago. I was before they had corpses and stuff. It wasn't like early access, but they've added a couple things to the game, and also I'm not that good, so this might still be interesting. I kind of had a, I've had a couple of tries, and by tries I mean these are just me trying to start it just to make sure that the stream works. I'm gonna go ahead and erase these if that's all right, because there can only be one Dark Captania, and we're gonna play on Radiant because I suck. I know it's all right, and we're gonna just call it Dark Captania because my desktop dungeons kingdom is literally right over the hill from here, so they have to differentiate by calling it Dark Captania and Red Captania. I've had a couple mods on here, but this is gonna be for the most part, modless, because some of them are just they make the game a bit easier, though I think in a way it makes the game make more sense. Because let's be honest here, okay, T-Pose Leper is way too broken. I might just turn it on though. Let's see. These two only affect what would you call that? Aesthetics and the All Class Riposte mod. That doesn't make the game harder or easier, it changes it a bit. And I'm gonna leave that off anyway. Level restriction removal, that one, I'm sorry, it makes the game make more sense, but I'm gonna leave it off because it does technically make the game easier. What that means is that once your guys get too strong, they won't go into the beginner dungeons anymore. And that just doesn't make any sense to me, because you can still go in there and get, you know, murdered or half insane. Why are you so prideful? Heirloom stackers definitely have the question. I just got that to see what it looked like. And the all seven skills. Oh my gosh. I really want to use that one. But we're not going to. We're not going to. You know why? Because, well, I don't know. I just feel like we're missing out on some of the empathy if we do that.
You will arrive along the old road. It winds with a troubling, serpent-like suggestion through the corrupted countryside, leading only, I fear, to ever more tenebrous places. There is a sickness in the ancient, pitted cobbles of the old road, and on its writhing path, you will face viciousness, violence, and perhaps other damnably transcendent terrors. So steel yourself, and remember there can be no bravery without madness. The old road will take you to hell, but in that gaping abyss, we will find our redemption.
We crashed. All right, time for the tutorial level. It's all right with me. The old road, with the stagecoach destroyed and the caretaker gone, you will have to make their journey to the hamlet on foot. No worries, I don't know how the caretaker lives, but he somehow does. Okay, so when the game starts like this, it actually shifts things down a bit. So let me go and fix that. And there we go. I was afraid that would happen. Thankfully, I'm being smarter than I was earlier with streaming. Okay, so it's just going to teach me about how to play the game. The main lifeblood of the game is treasure, I'd say. Well, experience. Experience and treasure.
Brigands have run up these lanes. Keep to the side path. The hamlet is just ahead.
And, you know, like the Twitch notification saying, this is kind of intended for more mature audiences. Especially when we get to a certain boss who's topless. I'll just do my best about that.
In brutal fashion, that all may hear of your arrival.
Alright, so I know how to do this. Granted, I love Grape Shot Blast, but we're just going to have to open a vein. Alright, so it's Radiant. It's not too hard right now, but A, this is a tutorial level, and B, oh, I didn't stun him. Well, you know, it's. I think the tutorial level actually makes it even easier than it normally does. That's cool.
Give them no
loot! Alright, 500 gold, I'll take it. Unfortunately, we're just gonna have to live with that bleeding. That's alright, though. And Reynald will be just fine. I like to think that the reason why his name is Reynald, by the way, is because he does learn a move, Zealous Accusation, which he holds out parchment paper. You see where we're going with this? Reynald's parchment paper. Reynald wrap. Okay, so we're just gonna go ahead and interact with this. It should be safe. I am already starting this game fairly advantaged.
There is much to be found in forgotten places.
Why? Because I've played this game before.
The rightful owner has returned, and their kind is no longer welcome.
Okay, I can't switch whose turn it is. We're just gonna be basic AF. It's alright, no problem. I would like to stun the big guy, though. He does, like, AoE stuff. So, like I said, I'm advantaged. I know what the enemies can do, and I know the interactive objects kind of well. Somewhat. I mean, I'm gonna be honest, I'm gonna make some mistakes here and there, but, you know, I'm not a brand new player to this. That's mostly just stress. And the bleed. Ooh. I like how you can hover over this to see it. Tell you what. It might actually make more sense to just try and shoot him. We can actually hover over this and see. I'm going to do 5 to 9 damage. I think I might just try bleeding him out some more, although grape shot also makes sense. 75% chance to hit. It's only gonna do 3 to 5. It's not worth at all. Alright, there we go. We got some bleed going, especially since he's not resistant to bleed anymore. Or less resistant. The will to fight. We're losing our dodge, though. Alright. Zealous? No, it's not worth it. He's taking up 2 spots. We'll stun. Don't move. Damn it. Okay. It's alright. No problem. Reynald's just dying, that's all. It's no problem at all. Thank you for dodging. Much appreciated. Okay, so as long as we take out him, I think he becomes not very good when he's in the front row. Okay, there we go. But he's a corpse. This is new, but I'm still aware of it. Exsanguination be considered a virtue. When most monsters die, they leave corpses. Corpses act as temporary obstacles and will eventually go away on their own. You can attack corpses to destroy them faster, but often a better approach is to use ranged skills, push-pull skills, and even corpse clearing special skills that some heroes possess. Monsters killed with bleed, blight, or crits leave no corpses at all. That's an important thing. Alright. What can you do, my friend? I can mark myself. Oh, that'd be great. I guess we'll just hack through the corpse then. And the bleed's helping. Alright. There'll be no blood left for the leeches! There's nothing I can do. If I go stealth, he can only shoot him, and I don't like that idea, so yeah, let's just get rid of the corpse. For the first tutorial thing, this is actually not going very well. It's normal for you to go through this without anybody even coming close to dying. Alright, stun him, please. Thank you. He's no longer bleeding. We're no longer debuffed. Let's not kill him, because I hate that. And he has a stun buff, or stun resist buff now, so we'll just do our best to take him out. If Reynold dies, I'm still going to carry on, but I'm going to be peeved. Alright. Now here's the annoying part. That overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer. Completing a quest after you've completed the... Okay, yeah. You can read that. Quest complete. I'm going to continue adventuring, because there's a box here. Bandit's trap chest. Something doesn't look quite right with this one. I mean, we don't have, like, keys or anything, so we're just kind of going with luck here. It's trapped. No problem, though. It tried to blight me, which is like poison. So we can leave now by clicking that. Alright, Reynold and Dismas did a good job. Alright, next. Alright, real quick, I'm just going to make sure. Yeah, everything's coming through just fine on Twitch. Alright, so Dismas... Well, they both leveled up, actually, but only Dismas got a negative. For some reason, he has a love interest, so he's only going to go to the special place. But he did learn better critical chance, so cool. That's awesome. I'm going to be honest, I don't really care about traits so much until such as it is. This later in the game. Hamlet, these corrupted lands, they are yours now, and you are bound to them. Mm-hmm. No problem. We keep our stress. That's alright. We keep our stress, but we heal all our wounds. Get help where you may! Okay. I like this. It's actually pretty helpful. I'm not gonna use it too much, though. Okay, so most of these buildings we can't actually do anything with. I'll go and click on them just to... We'll end up here, covered in the poisoned earth, awaiting merciful oblivion. I don't know if that's how you feel about it. I mean, the graveyard doesn't really matter. If somebody dies, they go to the graveyard, and we'd have to get Monster Reborn to bring them out, and I forgot what else happens after that. Stagecoach! Women and men, soldiers and outlaws, fools and corpses. All will find their way to us now that the road is clear. Okay. Okay, cool.
Sister of battle, pious and unrelenting.
Okay, that makes me actually kind of mad because the Plague Doctor did not get their introduction. Upgrade the stagecoach. Yeah, I understand how that works. We need to find things to upgrade our stuff with. I don't really know how I feel about this. We can hold 8. This will make it so we can hold 12. 2 will come at a time. Experience recruits. I'm gonna be honest, I don't really feel like that's a worthwhile investment. I might be wrong though, I'm probably dead wrong. That's okay.
Trinkets and charms gathered from all the forgotten corners of the earth.
Now, one thing I have learned is my speed can actually be pretty bad. Makes it so that you're guaranteed to go last. There isn't much more you can do in town right now. It's time to embark on a quest. All right, we'll do that. No problem. Real quick though, we're not finished here. All right, right click them. All right, so Plague Doctor is actually, if I remember right, female, but I'm gonna follow tradition and name it after my brother. Why? What? You didn't like the name. Let me try that again. Risky Monk. There we go. And the backstory behind that is that Risky was born with not very good muscle development in game. In real life, he's fine. He's actually a huge fan of Plague Doctors for some reason. He likes poison characters, so this fits perfect. Hang on, I need to check something. Twitch, are you okay? All right, good. It's good. And so he grew up learning more about the scalpel and the poison than through sheer attack. And as such, the only armor he could find actually only fit women. And that's why the breastplate has, breasts. So, there's your story. I'm sticking to it. It's not like it matters. Last time I lost Risky to a boss, so... Oh, did I say that out loud? Alright. And... Oh, wait. Hang on. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You can actually change their clothing. And Risky is all about the green, so we're gonna go with that. And you... I could have sworn there was, like, a mod that makes it so that your, Seeker Vestal looks like a white mage. I don't remember ever downloading it, though. I think the closest we'll get to white and red is this, which is just red. It's alright. A sister of battle, indeed. Let's name her after my own sister. Huh. In a way, that kind of doxes me if anyone knows who this is. That's alright, though. I don't really care. It doesn't dox us completely. Alright, and Dismas and Reynold will stay the same. I am a highwayman, but I'm not the first highwayman. I'm not sure how we're going to name myself into this, actually. Especially since, you know, wouldn't that mean that I become the king piece? Once I die, the game is over, period. No matter how well everyone else is doing. I was actually considering that. There's a lot of mods out there. There's like a mod for yourself, or a mod to get a heir, you know, H-E-I-R. And I was thinking, you know, maybe I could do that and name it myself. And the rule would be I'd have to go at least every 4 weeks, once every 4 weeks. And if I die, the game's over, period, in a sentence. But I don't know. That's risky. And I'd have to turn on a easier mod to make it worth it. I don't know. All right, so we have both of them in the party. Oh, here we go.
Of madness and morbidity.
Your quest and parties. All right, that's cool. You can read that. Risky does best in the back, and the Red Hook team just means that, you know, the first 4 heroes you get, you put them in this kind of formation, and things are great. If you put them in this formation, they're called the usual suspects. But I don't think it really matters. We can change their makeup on the fly, actually. Let's just go to the ruins. Alright.
The preparedness measured now in gold, later in blood.
Alright, so we need provisions. We're not going to be camping, so food's not super important. Let's take enough for two eatings. We'll take two shovels just in case there's something in the way. We got a free anti-venom just for taking a plague doctor, and one free holy water for taking a crusader. It's always a good idea to take torches. I'm going to take eight. In fact, watch this. Alright. Whoa! Okay, that's new. It's normally supposed to warn you, hey, you didn't bring any torches. Are you sure? Okay. Well, time to pay for my folly. I just wanted to show you the warning message. Okay. Alright. What moves do you know? She knows how to heal. She knows how to heal everybody. And she can punch the enemies. Alright, that's good. Please tell me you know the plague grenade. Good, okay. That's what I count on. That's what I need. Oh, wait. Reynold, are you a klepto? He is. Shoot. He's always a kleptomaniac. Alright, this is good. Give me a torch.
For a task well performed.
We're gonna need it. Right now, we're more or less just trying to get through this, so let's keep things lit. Alright. At least I brought food before, it was stupid. These guys can't be really bled, they got bleed resist out the wazoo. Feel free to check out somebody's YouTube video on actually making one of them bleed, though, because it's funny. Other than that, though, I just kind of want to try this. I want to turn invisible. Did that turn me invisible? No. Okay, they may be made of bones, but they're still weak to acid. Let's do that. This one? How strong is the acid? Resist? You had a 10% chance to resist, I think. I don't really need any of these right now, but if you don't make her do something, she'll get stressed, so cool. And de-stress just a little bit. Ow. Alright. Stunning blow. I don't think it matters. Cool. Nice stun there. Maybe I should have stunned the other one. That would have saved a hit. A potential hit. Pistol shot. Where's my stats? Like, normally it tells me, hey, you have this chance to hit. There it is. That's a pretty good hit. Let's kill the one that's not stunned. And if possible, yeah, I'd like her to heal him. A well-healed party is a happy party. Risky, you gotta stop missing. No point in stunning. I didn't bring any keys. It's alright. It's unlocked anyway. Ah, another shovel.
Could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
Alright, so this one, if I remember, we're supposed to just beat or explore 90% of the rooms. Oh, good thing we got a shovel.
Even the cold stone seems bent on preventing passage.
Yeah. Normally you get an item to check out, or, you know, to throw into here to make something happen. But it doesn't tell you what to do. You gotta figure that out on your own. Except for Rubble, it's like, yeah, we better tell them what to do or they're gonna try and dig it out themselves. And then everyone gets super stressed and starved, I think. Okay. I don't like her. She stresses the party out, and I just don't have any way of dealing with that. So, let us either acid her or disorient her. 100% chance. But she's got some stun resist. Let's try it anyway. And it shuffles her too, so she'll be moved more to the front, which is good. Since there's three of them, let's go to Grapeshot Blast. Yeah. Alright. And she's not close enough to do anything except heal, so I don't think anybody needs it, though. Now they do. Such is the pain of being slower than your healer. Okay, he can also do a double attack. It's going to be 4 to 8. Yeah, okay. Let's go for it. I like AoE damage because it seems more efficient. Great. Please finish her off. Thank you.
Destroy them all.
Let's heal Reynold. Just keep him fully healed. Okay. As you can see, our white mage is not going to be able to keep up with this.
Executed with impunity.
I know, I called her white mage. It's a Vestal. It's alright. Don't worry about it. Who needs healing more? I feel like it's Disney. Alright. Alright, that's good. That's okay. And then it can be Reynold next. Pistol shot?
Another one falls.
Now, let's take off.
Victory, but a victory nonetheless.
Question. How come we can't heal out of battle? And, you know, I've thought about that for a while, and my headcanon says that our heroes are actually somewhat normal people most of the time. It's only when they're within room's reach of Lovecraftian horrors and the unforeseen that something within their soul wells up and like they gain these powers, whether it be poison, healing, stabbing, or being a knight. That's my opinion anyway.
Glittering gold,
cool, we got a key.
Trinkets and baubles.
Baubles.
Paid for in blood.
Just Dismas's blood. Don't worry about it. Oh, hey. Just in time for that key. Oh, we just got ambushed. This is why it sucks if you don't bring, torches. Okay. Just do damage, guys. Time for stress. And darkening, too. Oh. Let's disorient her more toward the front. Didn't stun her though. It's okay though.
Grievous injury. Palpable fear.
Palpable fear. Alright. We need these guys to move forward. But if I move back, it's just gonna put Risky at the front. That doesn't make any sense. It's okay though. We got this. I should've used Hand of Light.
Just lapse in concentration.
Okay. Shoot. And then you move back. Okay, that's good. I can still snipe from here. I have a good chance at taking this guy out instantly.
Another
nice.
Abomination.
Good.
From our lands.
Very well done, Cappy. Or whoever you are. Stunning makes sense. I'd rather take some stress damage than him killing the white mage, so let's do that. Okay. Hand of Light. It's not worth it. Let's just move him to the front. In fact, I should, probably should have just had her heal herself. Noxious Blast. Yeah, if we can kill him, that'd be great. Okay, so he's going to die in the next turn. He's got 5 health left. He takes 5 damage from that each time, so we don't even have to worry about him anymore. He's done.
But death by inches.
Exactly. Alright, that's okay. She might stress out. No prob. Let's just heal the party and hope for the best.
Can be healed, but never hidden.
Stun, stun, stun. Good. Okay, we got another turn of healing, which I need. Shoot. You know what, let's splash her. I don't need you stressing out too. Let's just move you forward.
Slow death, unforeseen. unforgiving.
Okay, this is fine. This is actually not fine. Move forward, please. Alright. So this one's actually locked. It doesn't say it's locked, but it is. And if we don't use a key here, there's a chance we might get bled or blighted or something. And we get more treasure by using a key, I think. I wish I had more torches. So much blood. We're gonna get ambushed like heck.
Secrets
traps
and wonders can be found in the most tenebrous corners of this place.
Okay. So I think we just need to discover this room, and this room, and we're good. We don't need to do that one. It rounds up, I hope. Oh, here comes this kleptomania. What'd we lose out on? Oh, good stuff. Oh, speaking of, if we're low enough on health, we can actually have some of our party eat. It's a last-ditch effort, but it's sometimes necessary. And now they're all hungry. That's okay. If I didn't feed them, they would all stress out like heck and even lose some health. Okay. One more hallway, one more room. Before we send the White Mage to her doom. Oh, man. Oh, cool. A shovel. Yeah, do it. We only get like a quarter of the money back for whatever we bring back, so I don't really mind wasting shovels, so to speak. Oh, good. We didn't get ambushed. You, I definitely want you to plague grenade. It'll kill these guys very quick, if it works. That worked on him, and I hate him. Tempting goblet. All right, time for her to stress out. Okay, now she's paranoid. That's all right.
The walls close in. The shadows.
She doesn't trust her party anymore.
Afflicted.
When heroes can't take the stress anymore, they become afflicted. This manifests in different behaviors and stat changes. Afflictions last until you send them to treatment in town unless you can reduce their stress to zero during the quest, which is not happening. It's possible. Well, it's just not happening. I'll shoot the front three. Yeah, that works.
Maintain the offensive.
This is not a good first mission, by the way. This does not bode well for how this whole thing's going to go forward in the first place. I think a full party heal makes the most sense. At least she healed everybody. She didn't say, no, I don't trust you. Alright. I could hit the front two. Let's do that.
Well struck.
Good. That helps. And when you crit, you get a slight buff for one round. It's different for each class. The things you learn. This guy has protect on. But I still don't like him even more. Let's disorient him to the front. There we go. And destroyed the corpse too. Yes, just keep healing the party. Oh, that was really good heal, actually. I can only snipe him, that's alright. I'll take it. Dead weight. Oof. That's gonna be some stress for you, Dismas. And everybody. And a stun, too, on top of it. Okay. Let's finish off the guy in the back.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Hello, MegaWolf620. Sorry I didn't see your message until now. I'm doing this on one screen, actually. Which actually kind of makes it a little difficult, believe it or not. Hang on. My OBS is not showing the cursor. One second, I want to change that. We can change that, right? Output. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Video? I know it's in here. I've seen it before. Sorry, I'm just taking a minute. Keep recording. Da-da-da. Automatically start replay buffer. That's cool. System tray. How do we show cursor? I know it's in here. I could have sworn I've seen it before. Okay. I'm thinking we just don't have it. I'll get it figured out for next time. No problem. Alright, let's finish it off. We got this. We have a stressed out white mage, we have an almost dead knight, that's alright. It's a party heal because she's not in the right slot. Thank you. Okay, is this the last room? Yes, it is. Alright.
So too will resistance.
We'll keep the torch because there's really no reason to. If it's dark, you actually get more treasure from treasure chests, potentially. I think we can open it with a shovel. The item had no effect. Okay, that's fine. Bandages? The item had no effect. It wastes it, but we are. It does mark it for later, and we'll figure it out. Okay, open it. Contents are mine.
Wealth
all right.
Beyond measure, awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
One potential we can do is go back to that room, but I don't like how we're doing right now. Believe it or not. Not bad on the loot. The heirlooms are actually looking pretty good too. We need crests for everything. We need busts for certain things that are like medically related if I remember right. Okay, level, that's good. What'd you get, Reynold? You're winded and a fast healer. Okay. What'd you get, Minayu? Weak grip. Okay, that's terrible. It's going to bode very poorly for my melee white mage strategy. If you can't tell, I don't care. Plus 5% scouting chance in warrants. Alright. Excellent. Very excellent.
The tents are pitched, banners fly, and the corpse wagons stand at the ready.
Yeah, okay. My chat is showing up.
Come to town.
Over time, some negative quirks will lock into place and become severe. Severe negative quirks cost much more to remove in the sanitarium. But at the same time, they can't go away by being replaced by other ones, so in some cases you like that. The Butcher's Circus. A traveling circus has arrived on the outskirts of town, bringing with them all manner of crude sport. Enter the ring this week to relieve 10 stress from all heroes. That's not a whole lot, and I have no idea what the Butcher's Circus is. It's an update. It's a recent update, but I have no idea what it is. Butcher's Circus is now unlocked. You know, let's hit H. Right-click on a hero. Okay. So, cool. The Dark Captania Estate. Where is the Butcher's Circus? It's over here. Compete in the ring. Download the Butcher's Circus DLC. Okay, cool. It's a DLC anyway. I'm fairly certain I have some of the DLC. Or do I? I don't remember. And that's okay. I'm playing vanilla right now because the blood... the one about the blood... I can't remember what it's called. That one DLC that involves blood. And you'll know what I'm talking about if you know the DLC. Looks advanced for me. Very advanced.
In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.
Alright, so here's what's interesting. There's a tree growing around it. The statue's half broken down. But it's, you know, fully there. We can actually play some of the older things or anything that he says about certain bosses. That's kind of cool. Let's see here. Wasn't there something I could do here about, I think I need to bring it back first. I need to bring back stories to fill up the story wagon. Well, the story statue. Tavern!
Fresh kegs, cards, and curtained rooms promise solace to the weary and broken alike.
Heroes relieve stress by taking part in activities in the Tavern of the Abbey. Experiment to find the best... Okay, so they had this whole religious versus non-religious thing going on, and it feels like it was kind of something that was worked on but then somewhat abandoned. Because, you know, here is some unreligious ways of relieving stress. And then the Abbey has the religious ways of relieving stress.
Dusted, the pews set straight. The Abbey calls to the faithful.
And really, you can put people anywhere unless they have a certain trait that doesn't let them. I'm through the solitary pursuits. I pine for the company of my lover. So he's only going to go to the brothel. Thankfully, the game unlocks all three for us at the start, so it's not like we're messed up on Dismas. We might as well check out the stagecoach. We got a leper. We got a houndmaster. Both of those are... Well, actually,
this
I don't...
This man understands that adversity and existence are one and the same.
I regret that. I mean, I don't regret recruiting the leper. I regret doing that too fast, because then we lost out on the introduction, but... Yeah. So, we got our T-posing leper. That's cool. He's a secondary tank. He is one of the most unbalanced classes in the game in the worst way. As in, not a good way. The Houndmaster, on the other hand, is actually pretty good. Pretty good at scouting, pretty good at tanking. I don't really want to upgrade anything. Let's go to the... complete more quests unlock. Alright, we need to heal Manayu. And this is a problem. Let's have a look at what quests are available. Okay, our ruins leveled up. Do not cast your gaze upon me. I know you're foul, Cinch. We can only go to the ruins right now. There's a few different quests we can do. Cleanse. Why would a camouflage cloak make it so that we don't have stun resist? I don't know. We did get treasure. Let's head back. Let's check the inventory. Okay, we got a stun stone. And while stun stone is great, it would make so that Reynold's stunning blow would be more effective. That minus one speed hurts. It hurts a lot. That's how much speed he has. And the way speed works in this game is that whoever has more speed will go first, though everybody rolls a dice at the start, an invisible dice that you don't see. And it rolls from 0 to 8, and it adds that on to you. So it's not like you're always going to be outsped by somebody, unless they're 8 faster than you, and that happens a lot. Oh no! Reynold is now almost permanently a kleptomaniac. The sanitarium is still locked, so we can't fix that. In fact, I think with it being on there semi-permanently... Oof. I don't know. I think we might just send Manayu in there, as paranoid as she is. I need a healer. I really do. I wish all the stress went on to Dismas or Reynold, because I could easily... just use the Houndmaster for this. That's alright. That's alright. You know what, Reynold? You're going last anyway. Let's just equip it. Alright. How do we do this? Something like this? Yeah, now he has zero speed. Hooray. Okay. Let's do a short one. We just need money to relieve... Well, you know what? Let's put Manayu... Manayu likes to drink. You go ahead and drink up, Manayu. That's alright. No problem. Relieve that stress. And we will put the Houndmaster in. Alright, what do you know? You don't know all 7 of your skills off the bat. We need the guild for that. In fact, did we unlock that? Nope. Not yet. Soon. Very soon. So, he knows how to heal himself. That's good. He knows how to buff allies and dodge. Hound's Harry is actually pretty good, just not against bone enemies. And, yeah, this is actually isn't that great for the ruins. But you know what? We're screwed either way. He can do everything he wants to from where he is. And that's great. That's wonderful. And that's lemon and lime. Complete 100% of room battles. So, no matter what, we're gonna have to fight. This one. Explore 90% of rooms. That one we may not have to fight so much. Okay, so the main thing I'm looking at then is the rewards. And for some reason... Oh, it's because these two are mediums. That's why. Okay, so let's make it short for sure. Oh, hey! A Dazzling Charm. It has no speed... down. Let's go for that. Okay. This time I won't be stupid, or as stupid. We're gonna take the food. We get a full refund if we sell from this menu, by the way, no worries. Let's take a couple manages, couple keys, one holy water is enough. And let's take 8 torches. And laudanum only cures madness, and it just doesn't come up very often. Let's take one torch, one shovel. We'll probably find more shovels along the way, and we have an antivenom. All right, that's cool. We need room for treasure, by the way, so that's why we're kind of not loading up too heavy. There's also another reason not to have too much treasure, and his name is Mr. Scary Face.
The fiends must be driven back, and what better place to begin than the seat of our noble line?
I do want to say something, though. One reason to make sure your formation is how you want it is if you do this, you can actually put everybody where you want them, how you started the dungeon, with just a single click, which is cool. It's cool. Scouting. Oh, thank you. All right, so since we know where the battle is, we can't be ambushed with it. I don't think we have a guaranteed chance of ambushing ourselves, but yeah. Okay, so we gotta beat every room battle. Hallway battles don't count, but you still don't want to run away from them. Okay, this is very strange, but my D key stopped working. Okay, there we go. Never mind. Alright. Bones. Okay, we ambushed them. Good. One free turn. Just do what damage you can, guys. Hound's Harry doesn't do much damage. Hound's Rush, I will do more damage. I do like the idea of killing them. We can also guard an ally and buff them for 10 dodge. That might be worth doing, actually, but 1-2 or 4-7. I feel like a 4-7 is actually a wiser choice. Let's try and take out one of the archers, because they do more damage. Oh, right. Plague grenade. Alright. Are you... He's not doomed. For some reason, our plague grenade didn't do a full thing. Sometimes it's 4, sometimes it's 5. I don't understand it. Unfortunately, Reynold, with his skill set, is really more for being in front and taking care of enemies in the front. So, we're just going to do damage.
Executed with impunity.
The more of them that are dead, the less of us that get hurt. Good dodge. Okay. So, we don't actually get a free turn, it's just that everybody gets to go first. And then they get a turn. Otherwise, you know, this could have been handled very quickly. You're dead. You're not. Let's take care of that. Okay. 4. And he has 4. Okay, so these both are doomed. Very good. We can only lick our wounds. It'd be weird if he was licking Dismas, let's be honest. I think we'll do that. Okay. Good. And then, what? Take him out?
As the yeah. Fiend falls,
and then he goes. Blossoms. And then the corpses explode. Yeah. All right.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They so can be beaten.
Okay, this thing. Decorative urn. If I remember right, you want to pour holy water into it, right? Yeah. Treasure. Each of these are worth, well, these are worth 250, these are worth 375. In some cases, you, even though we have more of these, we might want to throw them away for a slot of these because we can hold more gold that way. Particularly since citrines, you can actually hold more of a stack of gold than you can a stack of citrines worth. So, yeah, it's kind of funny. 75 darkness, I'm not worried. Okay, I'm worried. Scouting, okay, that's good. Scouting chance really counts on your light. Alright. So we're doing all the room battles. So we don't know where all the enemies are unless we scout. I'm thinking we're just gonna go boop, 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 Oh, wait. You can't see this, can you? I mean, you can, but it's really weird. It's like I'm my screen. My actual cursor is 20% of the way down the screen. Right now, I'm on the door. Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna have to get that fixed. I really apologize, but we're gonna go to this room, the room just north of it, room just west of it, room just south of it, just room south of it. We'll ignore the hallway in the middle. It'll be fine, no problem. Oh no, it's not fine. Okay, it is fine. I hate these things. Wanna know how else I'm advantaged? Slightly? I actually played this game with my brother. We haven't beaten it. And he lost a white mage to these. Your plague grenade sucks. Oh, okay, this one does 5, and this one does 4. Okay, that makes sense. How resistant are they? Oh, they're somewhat resistant to blight. That's alright. So, I can take out one of the reds or one of the greens. I forgot which one is important. One of them marks and one of them actually hits. I'm thinking we want to kill the one that actually hits, so let's go for that. Plague grenade. 80% chance. Resisted, though. Oh, great. Hound's Harry, they're not very resistant to bleed. This is actually very good. Good. And now they're bleeding. They don't leave corpses either, because, I don't know, spires don't leave corpses? Does that make sense? No? Okay, that's alright. Nicely done, Reynold. Much appreciated. Okay, we had a chance at taking heavy damage on our plague doctor. Don't miss anymore, Reynold. Don't screw with me. Destroy them all. Okay. Another citron. I mean, it stacks up to 1250. If we get a whole stack of gold, that's 1750. So, I like him because I need all the money I can get, but, you know, if we start running out of space, I know what I'm going to do. Curio cabinet. You either want a key or another kind of key. The shovel. Yeah. A key is ideal, but sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. Let's keep the light lit. We don't have a white mage. I don't have much room to fool around here. Matt, please. Oh, another scout chance. Well done. I think it's because our houndmaster and our thief, I'm just gonna call him a thief, are actually pretty good at scouting, so we have a somewhat high chance at scouting. In fact, isn't there a key I? No, that's H. Isn't it? Hang on. There's got to be a way to see our chances of scouting. I could have sworn. All right, that's all right. No problem. We got to choose. All three of these are actually battles, so we're going to have to go to all three of them. That's all right. There's a trap ahead, a trap ahead, a trap ahead. That's all right. Well, we see them. Please don't forget they're there. We want the best trap avoider to do that. And 50% on thief. 40% on him. 30% on risky monk. And just 20% on Reynolds. So we definitely want the bandit to do it. Disarming traps. Okay, it even warned me to be there. Good. Scout traps will be visible on the ground as you approach them. Select here and then click. Okay. Yes. Now, it may sound like I only have a 40% or 50% chance of doing this, but it's actually higher than that because we see it. And it gets free stress, de-stress, which is great. And I'll leave the light off. Oh. Time to read an unsettling passage. Reynold, tell us what you read. An old journal entry. Okay, we want to take this back.
Treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
That might be one of my limits, or one of my negatives, is that I am knowledge thirsty, canonically. And so, regardless of what we're bringing home, we have to bring home any journal pages we find. So, we have good treasure? Too bad. Throw one of them out and take the journal page. It's not too much of a handicap, but still. Oh, right. It's dark, actually. It's okay. It's alright. We can try to stun them. They're not very good at, you know, resisting stun. We'll try it. Yeah, let's try it. Well, we stunned her. Both of them are really more or less the same enemy in my eyes because they do ranged attacks that stress. Woohoo. We have two bones, and you know what? I'm thinking about maybe pistol shooting her and hoping for the best. I'm not liking how this is going for Dismas, though. Now he's bleeding. Alright. It's okay. We can actually try to attack her from a range with this. Or we can bleed multiple. It's only one to two and two weak bleeds. I think I'll do the Hound's Rush instead. I don't need to heal. Well, I might actually want to help Dismas out. Let's keep him safe. If anybody targets Dismas, he takes her place instead. I am learning. Alright. This 4 to 8 versus 7 to 14. That's... wow. Hmm. Are you unholy? He is, but he's not. I'm just trying to take him out. Yeah. There we go. Less damage on our party. Okay. She's no longer stunned, or she has a stun buff, so let's not try to stun her again. Let's just miss. Completely miss. See, he took the place. Which is good. I need Dismas to not get too stressed either. Bandaging! Your hero is bleeding. If you want, you can use a bandage. I might as well. It wasn't a very strong bleed, and whether it's, you know, one bleed or way more bleed, the bandage will take care of all of it. It's also weird that this journal page is here. Okay. Snipe? I feel like snipe. There we go. This got a lot easier. And he's still guarded for, like, another round. Oh, wait. That doesn't last long, does it? You know, I have no idea how long it lasts, and that's okay. Let's try and take him out. Not bad. The bleed wasn't going to happen, let's be honest here. Maybe what I want to do is I want to try to keep him stunned. We have a stun thing, yeah, to help us with that. And if possible, Risky, I would like you to plague grenade. 73% chance to hit. Don't miss. Well, the blight didn't work. That's okay. You did your best. You did your best. The game gets better. Or our guys get better at their skills. No worries. I'd rather take him out. Give them no quarter. Now they just have corpses. And a bleeder on their front lines. That's a pretty good bleed, too, at two. Okay, finish it off. Did I miss any more messages? No? Okay. A bust and victory. A citron. Victory nonetheless. It only stacks to five. Okay. 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 It's alright. No probs. I don't have any source of healing aside from food. How strong is this bleed? We got one health from it. I'm just going to let it be. The bandage might be more needed elsewhere. Let's just put it that way. No battles on the way. Just a couple curios. Alright, so here's the thing. I'm thinking. Here we go. That's what it's actually looking like. We'll open it without unlocking it. How strong is that? Let's try another. Okay. He's got 4 damage to take, but he can heal himself, so I'm gonna hunger. It's fine. I got one anti-venom. You know what? Nah. Let's just go. Oh, right. Oof. I didn't know you could do that. I lit torches while walking through the door. I did not know you could do that. Thank goodness I did. Please plague them. Good. Good. Alright. Half bones, half non-bones. Hound's Harry's not worth it here. Healing yourself, though. Let's keep the heals up, because you're probably going to be protecting Dismas here soon. Let's be honest. And now they can take more crits, which is good. Good stuff. 3-7, 4-8, 7-15, that's not bad. It's almost the same, though, when you think about it. Let's just do double damage, because I like double damage, I really do. Nice dodge, by the way. But here comes a Chrysler. Oh, good, it was a dodge. Rend for the old gods. Wow, we are dodging like crazy. I almost feel like I'm cheating. Almost. Even though it's only going to do one damage, that will kill him. So it's actually worth it to do in this case. Yeah. A weak bleed, but a bleed nonetheless. And guess what? We can totally stack plague grenades. If it works. And it's it.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Yes. And she's doomed. I wouldn't mind if he had another turn to heal himself with, but I'd rather just end the fight early.
Slowly, gently. This is how a life is taken.
Making fights go on longer, is a skill that I haven't developed yet. Alright, if I remember right, this is actually something that like heals you or something. If you use holy water, it does something nice. We already used our holy water though, so what does this do? It healed us, okay. And it de-stressed us a little bit, that's good. Probably should have done Risky Monk though, because as the group's trapper guy, person, man, sir thing, I will lose some stress just from disarming the traps, that's what I meant to say. You, I only trust you with this. Oh good, 250 gold. We're not at 3. Oh, almost forgot. Good. Okay. Let's keep it lit.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear.
We came in here with 8 torches, and we've already used 6 of them. Just exploring a few rooms. Oh, I hope they drop a key. No, they're not going to, are they? It's alright. Alright. Bones? All bones. So I can do 2-4 and also make so they're more likely to be critted. Or I can do a 5-9 against one of these two. Let's go for that. If I'd known it missed, I wouldn't have done it, but then that'd be cheating, so yeah, it's alright. Good, we got one blight. Good dodge. Alright, so utterly useless here. Can't bleed them, and it's only going to do one damage. 1-2 in some cases, so let's just try and snipe out him. He's so close to being doomed. Blight doomed, I'll call it. I'll make millions. I'd say you're in for a zealous accusation. Where is he? Would a stun be better? Why am I wearing this if I'm not stunning? I like the damage. Thank you for dodging. If everything hits, it's just bad. And I hope that the wind isn't picking up too much on the microphone, but the wind's pretty blowing hard on the window right now. Alright. If we grape shot it will finish him off and make these two weak. I like that. I didn't mean it for to finish him off that way. I meant for the blight to work, but you know what? You do you, boo. Do we need to heal ourselves? If I could, I'd heal Risky, but that's just not happening. Let's snipe out the guy in the back. In fact, 95% chance to hit, 95% chance to hit. Yeah, everything's like 95. Okay, so I don't really feel too bad about trying this. Okay, he's doomed now. Good. We don't have to worry about him ever again. Nice miss. Zealous miss. Zealous miscusation. Maybe they just didn't care for what you had to say, Reynold. You ever think about that? Yeah, this makes sense. He was already blight doomed to begin with, but
the slow death.
Yeah.
Unforeseen.
I like Noxious Blast. Baja Blast. Now he's definitely dead. And let's just heal up. Because the strong guy's dead, the weaker guy I'm not worried about. Particularly now. Arr, matey. Alright. Hey, a key!
Be wary.
Okay, so that was every room battle.
It precipitates a dizzying fall.
Dizzying fall. Oh, wait. We had keys? I'm an idiot. But you knew that already. And our inventory is already filled up. That's alright, though. Let's go through here. Disarm a trap. Unlock the curio. Hope for the best. One, that's good de-stress for the thief. Oh. What was this? Was this a bandage? No effect. Okay. Was it a torch? No effect. Okay. See, it has a little X there. Maybe anti-venom. Nope. Shoot. I don't want to waste a key here. Keys are actually fairly valuable. I think it's holy water. Thief, check it. Okay. It tried to blight him. Now, we have to go forward because if we walk backwards, they stress out. There is a way to not stress out from walking backwards, but that's not how we're doing things. And it's not a mod, it's a positive buff. I forget what it's called. But we don't have that. Okay. I'm just gonna try and wrap this up. This is gonna be my first stream. It's only gonna be an hour long. There's a couple curios on the way. Let's hit it up. We'll leave it dark because we get better stuff that way. Salvage a torch and a couple crests somehow. Don't ask. Hunger. Yeah, go ahead and eat. And books. Yeah, do it. Unsettling passage. 30 stress. Okay, now what was in here? It's not a battle. It's also not a curio. Okay, we can leave. Right? Right. Okay, we're going. No prob.
More bones return to rest. Devils remanded to their abyss.
Again, not bad. And is there we go, 24 thingies and 6 bus. We're doing pretty good. We got another couple level ups. Oh wait, no we didn't. We got some working on the level up on the ways. Off guard. Oh, I hate that. Backtracker. See, no stress penalty when walking backward. He learned that from me. Thick-blooded. And more stress against beasts, but does more damage to Eldritch. But this is not that great for a plague doctor since they don't really do direct damage. They do poison damage. It's not going to affect the blight skill at all.
Let me share with you the terrible wonders I have come to know.
All right, It's great. I paid all that money, 1,000 gold, to remove 45 stress from Minayu. But now she's no longer paranoid, so that's great. Actually, wait. Can I look at that again? Quest goal: successfully complete your first foray in the ruins, defeat the apprentice necromancer, defeat the sonorous prophet, defeat the necromancer, and don't read too much into that. It's too spoilery.
The bellows blast once again. The forge stands ready to make weapons of war.
Mm-hmm. The blacksmith is good for anybody. We can send somebody there and upgrade their equipment, which will make it so that they are more accurate and do more damage, which is wonderful. Guild.
Make no mistake, we will face ever greater threats. Our soldiers must be ready.
Yeah. Guild is how we're going to make our skills stronger, but unfortunately, the best we can do right now is learn all 7, and that doesn't matter too much if you like the 4 you've got. When you have skills, you can turn some of them off and turn some of them on. We don't know anything else. Thing is, it's very expensive. Look how much gold we have. Look how much it'd be to just unlock one. This is why I like the all 7 skills thing, because it makes it, in some cases, you actually do want a battle heal, a holy lance, or an inspiring cry. And actually, inspiring cry is not bad. It really isn't. When you're up against certain fights that are not going to be very challenging. But I'd say we're going to prioritize the blacksmith first. And we do that. Oh, do we want... I think we want armor smithing. We can afford both, right? Nope. We're short just a couple of deeds. So we have to choose one. The furnace, I'm going to upgrade that last. Weapons. Why? Because
every plan relies upon a strong arm and tempered steel.
Because if the enemy's dead, you don't have to worry about defending. Now, do you? Alright. Get back in there. It's not just going to be Reynold. It's going to be everybody. Actually, it's not accuracy. It's, speed. And believe me, we want speed. Why do we keep doing this wrong? I don't know. But yeah, we went from 1 speed to 1 speed on Reynold. That's great. That really helped. And we went from 5 speed to 5 speed on No, we didn't. I can't read it anymore. It's gone. It's gone for good. So you actually do want to upgrade the weapons of somebody like a Plague Doctor, even though he's not going to do direct damage, because you want him to go first. Crude sachets, crafted sachets. Okay, so it actually tells you right here what it's going to do. 4-7 to 5-8. Again, I don't care so much for the base damage for this. It's more the speed buff, but it's money. How about you? Do you get a... Nope. No speed buff for her either. You haven't even done anything. Oh, you need to be level 1. Okay. You. What does he have? Does he have some sort of dog? No. Crude cudgel. Frayed collar. Let's go ahead and upgrade that. I like you. Okay. That's good. The guild. What do we need for upgrading that? We need portraits, which we have. And we need... Cress, which we got. Might as well do that. Okay, so we really want to upgrade what skills we like up to another level, because that's going to upgrade their accuracy as well as a little bit more to it. So let's see here. Just those 3 and that one. I haven't done this yet, but it is kind of worth it, especially since it adds... It's a free torch when you use it. I'm just not smart enough to remember that. Okay. Wicked Slice is not bad. Point blank shot's not bad, but it's very situational. Duelist Advance is not bad. I actually kind of like that. I'm probably going to switch off of this and get this. Remap combat skills. Heroes can only have 4 active combat skills at a time. Toggle the skills on and off to change your loadout and watch how it changes that hero's positional strength and display above. They're talking about... Here, let me show you. This right here. So I turn this off, everything just got a little bit weaker, but we turned this on, and yeah, so it's saying that he's really good at being in slot 2 or 3, and he really likes attack slot 2. Makes sense. When you have all 7 skills turned on, by the way, all 8 of these are just blaring red in most cases. Back to the guild. I really want to upgrade the Plague Doctor. Okay, those two are important. I do like the stun. I like emboldening vapors. It makes me basic AF, but that's okay. Alright. Just gotta remember. I don't care for Mace Bash. Judgment. Dazzling Light for a stun. Illumination will come into effect later. She's usually in the back, though, so let's choose something that really affects the back. So Judgment's actually not bad. Okay, I just gotta remember. Okay, see, the healing goes up. Healing goes way up. We're doing it. There's no point sending him to the guild for similar reasons, though, because, watch. Okay, we can unlock these, that's alright. But we can't do anything here until he's more than level 1. I'm not sure when we're gonna use him. Reynold's just so much better of a tank than him. Okay, and what have we not been using? We've used all 4 of these skills, actually. I really like the Houndmaster. They're like an A or an S rank class, in my opinion. And I also really like Target Whistle. I like Cry Havoc. I really like Cry Havoc. And I don't really care for Blackjack. So if I were to give up one, I'd probably give up Hound's Harry while we're in the ruins and switch it to... I'm not going to talk about marking. Marking is a thing that I don't think was implemented super well. Alright. We're going to do Cry Havoc. Okay, so let's just change everybody up just real quick. What do I not care about? Let's turn that off and turn that on. That's good. You can now buff friends with speed, which is great. It's really important, actually. Dismas, I already got you taken care of, right? Yep. And Reynolds, you're good. We're gonna turn off Mace Bash or Hand of Light. Mace Bash, let's be honest. And turn on Judgment. So now she can actually do some damage to the enemies, that's great. And you. We're gonna turn off Hound's Harry, but we're gonna turn on Stress, or De-Stress. And here's the nice thing about this, is that we can do this while we're in a dungeon, so if I have all 7 unlocked, that's not wasted money. It's still good. It's still really good. We spent most of our cash. We still have fairly stressed out guys. Let's check out the...
A sister of battle, pious and unrelenting.
Testing. Oh, it's working now. Okay. Not sure what happened there, but I got it fixed this time. Sorry about that. We're gonna just wrap this up real quick. I know, all the technical difficulties on the first step. Antiquarian's not a bad class. It's really more about playing the easy levels and getting even more money, if I remember it, because they make more money stack higher or something like that. I don't know. They're pretty good at it, though. And they find more antiques, so you can sell that for even more money. So it works. It just works. Yeah, but that's going to have to do for this episode. Thank you for catching my very first stream. I don't expect many people to come watch it. That's all right. I just kind of wanted to be here so that I could prove that, hey, I'm playing this right. I'm not scumming it, even though I don't think people really think I would do that. I just think, hey, we might as well stream just to see what that's like, right? Sounds good to me. I will see you in the next one. Bye.